Good evening and welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good evening. Welcome, family, friends, colleagues, and scholars. Congratulations to you, 9 scholars, on completing your health science teaching certificate. Can we give them a hand or congratulations in the comment box since we are virtual? Your dedication and hard work have culminated in this remarkable achievement, and we celebrate your commitment to advancing health equity through health education. Throughout your journey, you have demonstrated a profound understanding of the critical role that effective teaching plays in shaping the future of health sciences and digital learning. As you step forward as ambassadors of health science education, we are confident that you will now inspire and empower the next generation of healthcare professionals. Your completion of this amazing program signifies not only your mastery, but also your dedication to fostering a culture of excellence in health education. The world needs you, and the world needs passionate and skilled educators like you to guide students on their path to becoming informed, compassionate, and capable health leaders. As you embark on this new chapter, remember that your influence extends far beyond Canvas or the classroom. Your impact will ripple through the lives of countless individuals who will benefit from your knowledge, guidance, and mentorship. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our president and CEO, Dr. Valerie Montgomery Rice, our dean, who you will hear from next, Dr. Adrian Tindall, your amazing program director, Dr. Cheryl Houston, program manager, Ms. Sherry Peden, our instructional designers, one who is your peer in this program, Ms. Daye Danival and Ms. Anna Doctor, and the entire OEEP family, online education family, and Morehouse School of Medicine for the work you do each day to support online education. I would like to make a quick note and error in tonight's program. Gail McQuarrie works in the Department of Community Health and Preventive Medicine. Preventative medicine, not preventative. So that's a quick error that's in our program. Just wanted to make sure we pointed that out. Again, congratulations, 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 graduates. And may your journey as health science educators be fulfilling, impactful, and filled with continuous success. Thank you so much. I will now turn it over to our dean, Dr. Adrian Tindall.
Good evening, everyone, and hope you are all well. And Dr. Howard, thank you again for all of those warm introductions to this. So I'm Adrian Tindall. I'm the EVP of Health Affairs and Dean, as you all know. Delighted to certainly be here. And I want to say, first of all, congratulations in finishing this program. We understand the dedication that you actually bring to Morehouse School of Medicine. Most importantly, I think it's the intention of how you will actually use these skills in order to really achieve what it is that you hope to achieve. I'm excited by the program, the construction of the program, the idea behind this, obviously. And we want to ensure that we do everything as an institution to continue to advance your skills as we continue to promote health equity. And as we think about the process and where this is going to take us, which eventually would be to health justice. So again, I just want to say congratulations to all of you. We're excited by all of this, the work that was done. I certainly want to thank the staff and OEEP, Dr. Howard, for all the work that she's done, and everyone who was involved in the construction and the thoughtfulness behind all of this. But most importantly, I certainly hope you benefited from this in the way that you hoped. And I look forward to having conversations with all of you as you proceed now with newfound skills to do the work that we're here to do. So with that, I'll say congratulations and really have a wonderful rest of the evening. Dr. Howard?
Good evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Cheryl Houston, and I have the distinct privilege of being the Program Director for Health Sciences Teaching, as well as an instructor in three of the classes. I'm almost forgotten. I just have to say congratulations, graduates. It's really a moment for you, and I'm here to soak in the joy with you. When the opportunity to take part in the inaugural Health Sciences Teaching Program appeared, the individuals graduating today said yes. Despite busy home lives, in addition to the heavy lifting they do in their professional work, and for some, on top of their already very demanding graduate coursework, these folks said yes, yes, yes to a journey into the unknown. And for many, it was uncharted, very new territory for them. One of the hurdles that we had them go through in the process of the application was to submit and obtain permission from their academic department chair, graduate program directors, et cetera, in the form of a letter of support. And now I have the joy of presenting to the graduates, as witnessed by everyone attending tonight, a few congratulatory words from those individuals who supported, cheered, signed the form, and now celebrate with each of you tonight. So cue to that fabulous video we have for you.
Hey, Curie. Congratulations on completing the health science teaching program here at Morehouse School of Medicine. I had no idea 2 years ago when you interviewed me for a project that 2 years later, I would have the honor and the privilege to walk alongside you in your academic journey. I am so proud of the academic you are, of the Black woman you are, of the researcher you are, of the scientist you are. It is truly amazing to see the work that you're doing and the work that you are going to do. Congratulations again. Good luck. And I can't wait to see what you do in 2 more years. Bye, girl.
Thomas Cotton and Shantae McLaughlin, you both never cease to amaze me. I want to take this opportunity to say thank you. Thank you for taking on another task and successfully completing the teaching certificate program. You guys are awesome. We look forward to your continued success, wishing you the very best, and we're just about at the finish line with magic. Looking forward to seeing you at graduation. Have a great day.
Dr. Dodson, congratulations on completing your health science teaching certificate here through the Morehouse School of Online Education and Expanded Programs. You're already such a rock star. Now for you to add those skills is going to add to your superpowers. So I'm so excited to see how you're going to help to continue and transform the lives of our students through quality education. This is something that's very near and dear to my heart. So for you to be able to work with Dr. Houston as well as the rest of the staff to complete this program and these courses, it is just a joy for me. So I'm so excited to have you on my staff. I'm excited to see how you put in place some of the things that you learned in these courses. And I look forward to seeing where it takes us in the future as we shape the workforce. This is great. Congratulations.
Dara, congratulations on completion of another milestone in your journey towards becoming a successful MD-PhD academic. It's really exciting. Successful completion of this online course is a bold beginning of your enhanced development of your learner engagement skills as a subject matter expert. This also highlights your commitment to excellence in being an educator, mentor, of the next generation of learners, which is one of the three legs of being a future academic. Thus, I commend you on this accomplishment, and I am very proud of you. Kudos and best wishes. Best, B. Craig Bond.
Hello, Ndaye, and congratulations on completing your health science teaching certificate. I know from firsthand that you poured a lot into this, not only as a student and or as an instructional designer, but a person who really wanted to learn, a person who really wanted to take command and charge. So you certainly adjusted your schedule, strapped up your boots, and you got in and you did an amazing job. So congratulations, happy graduation. And I'm looking forward to seeing how you're going to integrate those skills that you've learned into what we do in OEEEP. Very proud of you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Dara. We're so very proud of you. I had no doubt that you would successfully accomplish this goal, especially given your excitement and enthusiasm for teaching and sharing knowledge with others. I just want you to know that we are so proud of you, and I'm thankful to have you as a mentee. And I just look forward to you accomplishing more of your goals and look forward to seeing the scientist and physician and teacher that you will be in the future. Again, congratulations.
Hi, Capri. Congratulations on completing the Health Sciences Teaching Certificate Program. Dr. Baldrick and I are so very proud of all that you have accomplished this semester and this year while you have been in the DHA program. We hope that this additional accomplishment will serve you well as you move forward with your educational journey, and we wish you all the best as you continue with your DHA degree. Congratulations again, and best of luck with this additional educational accomplishment.
Hi, I'm Tabia Akintobi, Professor and Chair of Community Health and Preventive Medicine. I am thrilled to say congratulations to Gail McCray, instructor on faculty in the Department of Community Health and Preventive Medicine, for her completion of her teaching certification related to this online education and expanded programs office, the Office of OEEP. You all have been amazingly supportive, and I am thrilled that Gail has graduated with this important distinction, which really builds upon all of her work in teaching, guiding, and educating not just community health workers, but academics and community leaders, all of those that need to work together to advance health equity. Gail, the Department of Community Health and Preventive Medicine is also proud of you and know you will continue to soar to even higher heights. Congratulations and kudos to you. Woohoo!
Hi, my name is Priscilla Pemu. I'm a professor of medicine and director in the Clinical Research Center. I am sending very warm congratulations to Dr. Tandika King-Gordon for completing this health sciences teaching program. Dr. King-Gordon, I am so proud of you for your vision, for your thoughtfulness, and for taking the time to get the training required for you to actualize your goals of being an academic and bringing value to the teaching that you do to all of our learners. This is how we lead in the creation and advancement of health equity. Congratulations, Dr. Tandika King-Gordon. I wish you well on your journey.
Wow, so amazing. Again, congratulations, graduates, and thank you all that submitted your videos. That was so amazing to hear from your leaders, hear from your colleagues, your mentors, and supporters. So once again, congratulations. Now I have the pleasure of of introducing such an amazing individual, such a wonderful individual who happens to be my chair, the best chair at Morehouse School of Medicine, the best programs at Morehouse School of Medicine. I have to say that because it is true, and she cooks really, really good for us. So that makes, that adds to the pot. But I'm super excited. You all have the program, so I won't read everything because we will be here until tomorrow if I read all of her amazing accolades. But I certainly want to give her her flowers at this time. So I'd like to introduce Dr. Janice Herbert Carter, who is the chair and professor of our Department of Medical Education, the best department at Morehouse School of Medicine. She received her bachelor's degree in biochemistry from Princeton, her master of general administration degree of healthcare administration from the University of Maryland, and her doctor of medicine from Howard University. Her postgraduate experiences include completing a primary care faculty development fellowship at Michigan State University of Human Medicine and her residency at Howard University Hospital in Washington, D.C. She is a board certified internal medicine and has published many peer reviewed journal articles and book chapters, as well as presented at many, many regional and state association meetings. Although Dr. Herbert Carter has a record of accomplishments and commitment to the mastery of her subject matter, content, and medicine, what brings her here today is by student request, her reputation and appreciation by all of her students and peers for her outstanding role as a quality educator. She is a didactic teacher of family medicine residents and students, and also teaches faculty development to help other faculty improve their teaching skills. Her interests include curriculum development, education of underrepresented learners, and faculty development, especially in the areas of diversity, equity, and inclusion. She was nominated by her peers and selected as one of the first four teachers of distinction in the Teaching Academy at Morehouse School of Medicine. So I hope that you're hearing that, students, because this is what you want to continue to strive as, to be a teacher of distinction. We are super thrilled, super excited to welcome Dr. Herbert Carter as the inaugural keynote speaker of our graduation for the learners completing the Health Sciences Teaching Certificate. Welcome, Dr. Herbert Carter.
Thank you, Dr. Howard. Good evening, everybody. I'm honored and grateful to have been invited to be the keynote speaker for Morehouse School of Medicine's first graduates of the Health Sciences Teaching Certificate program. Now, one thing I was taught as a faculty development fellow at Michigan State was, tell them what you're gonna tell them. Tell them what you wanna tell them. Then tell them what you told them. So I'm gonna start by telling you, you must always be primarily caring. That's a phrase I coined several years ago and which has become used by Morehouse School of Medicine to embody our ethos and succinctly express our mindset. The new version of Morehouse School of Medicine's vision is leading the creation and advancement of health equity to achieve health justice. Now, equality means everyone gets exactly the same thing, whether that's what they need or not. Health equity means that everyone will not need or get the same thing. Depending on your health status, age, family background, et cetera, some people will need certain things and more of them. Others will need different things or less of them. What we're ultimately trying to achieve is justice, where barriers that may be systemic, institutional, or personal are removed so that everyone can achieve optimal health. The mission of Morehouse School of Medicine states that we exist to improve the health and well-being of individuals and communities, increase the diversity of the health professional workforce and address primary healthcare needs with emphasis on people of color and the underserved urban and rural populations in Georgia, the nation, and the world. As you pursue your various careers incorporating health science teaching, I want to give you some insight on your future regarding furthering the MSM mission and vision, and some advice that I hope may serve you well, regardless of your future plans. At MSM, we recognize the importance of translating scientific discovery into real-world solutions for individuals and communities. We understand the significance of providing high-quality healthcare for patients, regardless of their socioeconomic status. We emphasize engaging and cooperating with our communities, local, national, and global. And we believe in educating students from diverse backgrounds to become the healthcare, scientific, and public health leaders of the future. These are the pillars upon which our strategic plan is based. Health justice means eliminating barriers that keep people from achieving the optimal health outcomes they deserve. Those barriers may be due to finances, they may be due to geography, they may be due to societal factors, but whatever, we at MSM are committed to eliminating them. So what does this mean for you as you receive your health science teaching certificate? It means you have responsibilities to the MSM mission and vision, to your future students, to your colleagues and families, to your communities, and to yourselves. It will be up to you to educate learners at various levels, from K through 12 to community college, four-year college, graduate school in various disciplines, medical school, and beyond. You will be preparing your learners to eliminate systemic barriers to optimal health, to engage with their communities to address healthcare disparities, and to enter a variety of careers that will positively impact their families and communities. It is these learners, your future learners, who will ultimately bring about health justice. In order for you to successfully educate your learners, whoever they are, you must be primarily caring. Each of you has a different career path. Students, faculty, and staff in the MD, PhD, Masters in Justice Involved Care, Doctor of Healthcare Administration, Master of Science in Biotechnology, Master of Science in Health Informatics Programs, the Office of Online Education and Expanded Programs, and the Department of Community Health and Preventive Medicine. Yet all of you can lead the creation and advancement of health equity to achieve health justice, regardless of your area. I'm saying that regardless of your field, you all must be primarily caring. Our communities are underserved in multiple ways. We certainly need physicians and PAs who practice primary care to do the pap smears, PHQ-9s, manual breast exams, digital rectal exams, hypertension treatment, HbA1c and glucose monitoring. We need those. But our communities also need access to subspecialists, research breakthroughs by biomedical scientists, and community interventions by public health professionals who are all primarily caring. We need instructional designers to help educate all our learners, leaders in justice-involved care to reduce recidivism, healthcare administrators who think about more than just the bottom line. Biotech entrepreneurs who understand the impact of their creations on real people, on the environment, as well as on shareholders' investments. Health informaticists who know more than just designing databases and writing code. Researchers who will help find ways to prevent the chronic diseases ravaging our society. And community health workers to guide our neighbors toward healthy behaviors, all of whom must be primarily caring. I'm asking you to care. Care about yourselves. Care about your families and colleagues. care about your learners, patients, and communities. You must care about yourself and do what you need to do to stay healthy and sane, even as you make your way through challenging careers. Take the time to eat nutritiously. No matter how busy you are, with a little planning, you can bring your lunch. It could be a peanut butter and banana sandwich on whole wheat bread that doesn't even need to be refrigerated, or some cheese cubes and apple slices. You don't have to rely on vending machines or fast food. You'll be working hard, and some of the problems you'll be facing will sometimes seem insurmountable. But when you do have time off, rest. Don't run around and try to do everything you couldn't do before. Washing the car can wait. Mowing the lawn can wait. Laundry can wait. Nobody ever died from wearing a dirty t-shirt. Prioritize and decide what's really important to accomplish in your limited time with your limited energy. Do use some of that energy to get some kind of exercise. Some of y'all know what my favorite exercise is: touch, hop, step, flap, drop. If you know, you know. Take time for your spiritual life, whatever form that might take. Be grateful for even small things. Maybe keep a gratitude diary to remind yourself of the many blessings you have. One year I had a mason jar, and weekly I added an index card with something that had occurred the previous week and for which I was grateful. That's a tangible thing you can do to remind yourself of your many blessings, especially when times get rough. Care about your families. You owe them. They may have supported you financially, sent you care packages in college, watched or will watch your kids while you're in the lab, fixed dinner so you could work late. Show them every day that you love them. That doesn't mean flowers and candy. It means a hug, a kind word, just a thank you. Care about your colleagues, all healthcare workers, all biomedical scientists, all public health professionals, all community members, all teachers. Demonstrate humility and show respect for your colleagues at all levels. We're part of a team. We're working together towards a common goal, and each of us has something valuable to contribute. And please know that you can learn a lot from those who are beneath you. As a resident in medicine clinic, I learned more about managing hypertension from the nurses than from any attending. In the lab, it's not only the PI who's important. It's the tech who sterilizes the glassware. It's the folks in the basement caring for the animals. In the community, it's not only the neighborhood association president or the commissioner of health or the church's pastor. It's also the barber who knows all his customers and their families. It's the crossing guard who makes sure the kids get home safely. It's the postal worker who knows everyone on her route. Everybody you encounter is struggling to do the best they can, often under difficult circumstances, especially at resource-poor public schools and county hospitals and in impoverished communities. Again, a thank you and a kind word will go a long way. When we're working together, help each other. Cooperate, don't compete. You're now about to be in a position to make a major difference in the lives of your learners and their communities. Maybe you won't make the mega bucks, but you will know that what you do matters, really matters. It will change lives. It's not important who's the president, who's on the Supreme Court, whether Congress is controlled by the Democrats or the Republicans. VMR, Dean Tindall, your department chair, your faculty mentor cannot by themselves bring about health equity and justice. You can care enough about our children, our families, our communities to make a difference. You have an obligation to make a difference. Now you may be thinking, what obligation? I worked hard to get where I am. But you do have an obligation to help your future learners and care for them, simply because they are human beings, your brothers and sisters. And goodness help you if you ever forget that and fail to treat all patients with respect and compassion if I'm your attending, or if you ever mistreat a human subject in your research or a learner in your program, or if you ever disrespect a community resident or justice-involved individual. You have an obligation to all of them because you are well-educated folks who've been given the privilege of becoming teachers, physicians, public health professionals, biomedical scientists, leaders. You owe every person who gave a little bit of themselves for your education. Did someone fill out a survey form for your community-based research? Did a patient let you stick their arms three times trying to find a vein? Did an incarcerated person let you interview them? Did a class of students listen to you practice teaching? Did an IT or AV person help you prepare and present a lesson? You owe them all. You owe it to folks you never even met, all those who came before you, who paved the way. As future health science teachers, you owe it to Mary McLeod Bethune, Jaime Escalante, and Fanny Coppin for seeing to it that you could get an education. You owe it to Nat Turner and Harriet Tubman, to Totanka Yotanka and every other person who fought, worked, and died so you could be free. To Carter G. Woodson, Sheikh Anta Jop, and Ivan Van Sertima for teaching you the truth about history. And please take your knowledge to Florida and share it. You owe it to those who, like John Lewis, were attacked on the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, Alabama in 1965, or beaten at the Stonewall Inn in New York City in 1969, or who were killed during the Wounded Knee Massacre in South Dakota in 1890. You owe it to Marcus, Malcolm, and Martin for writing, speaking, and suffering so you could have every right that every other person in this country has. You owe it to everyone who was herded like cattle through a door of no return and endured the Middle Passage across the Atlantic Ocean, who starved and froze on the Trail of Tears. You owe it to Trayvon, Michael, Eric, Sandra, Philando, Alton, Walter, Brianna, how many more names do I need to call, who died because somebody didn't care? You owe it to the founding leaders, staff, and faculty of Morehouse School of Medicine for making a place for you to learn. Lou Sullivan, Hugh Gloucester, Lavinia Bryant, Beverly Allen, Allie Cliff, Tom Norris, Cyril Moore. And if this, during this talk, I've called any names you don't recognize, and I know I have, Google them. You'll learn a lot. You must take the legacy that's been handed to you and continue leading this nation and the world toward health equity and justice until all lives really do matter, until every child is vaccinated, every smoker quits, every formerly incarcerated person can find a decent job, every neighborhood has grocery stores with fresh fruits and veggies, every city has clean air and water. And then, as healthy people, as healthy communities, we can all go forward to achieve the potential we were born to accomplish. As graduates of Morehouse School of Medicine Health Science Teaching Certificate Program, whoever, wherever, whatever, whenever you eventually teach, you must always be primarily caring. Thank you.
Wow, 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 wow. Thank you, Dr. Herbert Carter, for being a wonderful example of Morehouse School of Medicine's mission. Good evening, everyone, faculty, family, friends, staff, and graduates. My name is Sherry Peden, and I have the privilege of serving as the program manager for the Health Sciences Teaching Program. I am thrilled and honored to introduce our three student spotlight presenters. Please come to the stage in the following order: Dara Brenner, Gail G. McCray, and Thomas C. Cotton III.
Hi. Some think that we are good by nature, others by habit, and others by teaching. This program demonstrates we are made better through teaching. Our professor's genuine passion for teaching translated into educating our hearts. I was so eager to pursue this certificate as I have always been drawn to the intellectual creativity and flexibility that thrives within the academic environment, forming and reshaping ideas through dialogue based in diversity of perceptions and experiences is simply beautiful. This is one of the things I enjoy most about my current educational journey. Through this program, my draw to teaching deepened and I acquired valuable skill sets to promote a classroom environment conducive to idea sharing and collaboration. This was my very first exposure seeing behind the curtain on the science of teaching. Previously, I had thought of teaching as an art form. I had imagined professors jotting down ideas on a napkin as it came to them. However, now I know teaching is a science with a highly systematic methodology. I learned that courses are crafted specifically on observable, measurable student outcomes and placed very deliberately and in order to proactively maximize all students' learning. This program has not only solidified my commitment to becoming a health science educator, it has also paved the way for ensuring I implement effective, equitable, and inclusive course design. I sincerely thank you for this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you. To our course faculty, Dr. Cheryl Houston and Dr. Bill Sobator, to our faculty mentors, Dr. Jan Webster and Dr. Jessica Hilton, to the OEEP staff, Morehouse School of Medicine, to all who have contributed to this program, including our illustrious Dr. Janice Herbert Carter. We thank you, family, friends, and supporters for being here to take your time to celebrate with us our desire to be better at what we do, what we love. Congratulations to not the Divine Nine, but to the courageous and remarkable and distinguished Nine who took on the challenge of something new in the midst of an already busy schedule and saw it through, because we all want to be the best for any and all learners we encounter. We are all at different stages in our professional trajectories, some just getting started, some mid-career, and some like me, having invested well over 30 years in our professions. We represent different disciplines. I'm a health educator by training. I never had plans to teach, never took any courses along my educational path where I would learn the science and the tools of teaching. I've conducted community-based research and demonstration projects in health promotion and disease prevention and hypertension, cancer control, health literacy, bioethics, community engagement, and with the community health worker workforce. I've been teaching first-year medical students for many years. I was recruited, mentored by, and started co-teaching with one of the best community-oriented physicians that ever existed, Dr. Dan Blumenthal. Throughout my time in teaching, I felt I was missing something. And if I was missing something, then I felt the student learners may have been cheated out of my best to give. I appreciate this opportunity to share some of my thoughts about what being a part of this inaugural program means to me. We needed to learn so much in this online program. We got two very thick textbooks right off the bat, about 300 pages apiece. 14 by 17, not regular book size, like workbooks, but every page filled with text, no pictures. We learned a great deal of science, but I felt, as Dr. Houston described it, we would learn the tricks of the trade while she pulled back the curtain. We saw the whiz at work with teaching and learning principles and using technology to make the information transfer come alive. Some of the things I got most from this health sciences teaching certificate program include learning the science behind the various teaching and learning principles so that I can choose the most appropriate ones at the right time and implement them with confidence. Resources for top teaching and learning principles and where to find the information when I need it. Being moved out of my comfort zone and using strategies, including technology, for building both online and in-person curricula from the ground up with assessment tools that made sense according to the level of learners. Now, and with confidence, I can share with you that my teaching philosophy is student-centered, includes employing the best of the art and science of teaching, being well-prepared and encouraging the same with students, and being always passionate about my subject matter. If you make contact with our learners in any way, please make the time to take this certificate program. You will learn options to use when your usual teaching methods do not seem to work, and will build the capacity to reach into your toolkit for some new resources and strategies for teaching. And finally, fellow Health Sciences Teaching Certificate Program graduates, congratulations.
Hello, and thank you for allowing me to share a few words about the Health Science Teaching Certification. I want to say that teaching holds a significant importance to me because as I was growing up, I had many challenges learning, especially having so many trials in life. But there were specific teachers like my fourth grade teacher, Mrs. Johnson, who took a more personable route to teaching and made a lifelong impact on me. This helped me to develop my teaching philosophy, which is to create the space to develop a legacy of well-taught, engaged learners who can improve future generations. I didn't come from an academic background. I came from a life background that just wanted to pass knowledge on to other people. And as I developed my philosophy of teaching through this class, I put words to the philosophy I had. I had the action, but this allowed me to put the words to it. Now the philosophy leads to a process to help learners thirst for knowledge, enhance academic achievement, and improve critical thinking in order to develop lifelong skills that transfer beyond academics into various life domains. My teaching philosophy has allowed me to succeed with learners for decades. These learners are not in academic institutions. Actually, they're coming out of prisons. They're coming out of hard knocks in life. But I found that even people who have these challenges still want to learn. They still want to improve. They still want to advance. On top of that, I still want to advance. And that's the reason why I looked into the Health Science Teaching Certification. When this opportunity came up, I had a very demanding schedule. I have family. I was pursuing my master's degree. I have work. And I have other normal life things. I didn't know what to expect from this course, but I took a leap of faith. I felt that the timing was right, that the process of learning was important to me. I wanted to be able to understand some of the best practices in teaching, along with opening other opportunities to teach new groups of learners, such as those in higher education. Now that I'm through this course, I don't have enough time to tell you all that the ways that this program has transformed my teaching skills and understanding. All I can say is this has been a remarkable ride. One example is that I can now synthesize information in a way that has helped me structure a curriculum I developed 13 years ago into a more cohesive learning tool. This by itself would have made the program worthwhile. But wait, there's more. There are many other tools that I've gained to connect with learners, and these also have significant value. Tools that make me more aware of cognitive load for the students, structuring different live or online teaching platforms, and elevating the learning through scaffolding. This all makes me a better instructor, a better teacher, a better person who can just listen and have empathy with the learners that come through my classes. This health science teaching program has equipped me with tools to make the classroom experience better for all, including myself. It gave me the tools to improve and advance my philosophy of teaching. One thing that about this program that stood out to me is the faculty in this program, especially Dr. Cheryl Houston. They bring a level of engagement that makes knowledge and learning better for us all. Dr. Houston will now be added to the story of my teachers, like the fourth grade teacher that I have, who are personable and engaging. But don't let this fool you. She has a high standard and brings the best out of us to meet that standard. I want to thank you for teaching us and showing us excellence. I believe that all instructors to go through a program such as this. The systematic way that we do teaching now is so much better than when I first started. Even as I was going through my master's program, I could see places of improvement because of this training that I received here. In closing, I want to say this. As we navigate a world of ever-evolving knowledge, let us remember that teaching is not just a profession. It's a legacy we leave in the hearts and minds of others. It can be a beacon of hope that lights up their path and those that they meet to have a better and healthier future. Thank you.
We will now announce our inaugural Health Sciences Teaching graduates. Capri A. Bell, Dara Brenna, Thomas C. Cotton III, Kyrie M. S. Kruda, Indaye Gray Danipal, Ebony Dotson, Tandika King Gordon, Gail G. McCray, Shantae McLaughlin. Congratulations, scholars! You did it!
Thank you so much, Sherry. That was wonderful. And thanks to everyone who made this possible. First and foremost, I would be remiss if I did not personally thank the faculty who supported me and the learners throughout this process. Certainly Dr. Jessica Hilton, Dr. William Sobator, Dr. Jan Webster, and you met Sherry. She's a dynamo. Our HST program manager makes all this look easy, doesn't she? But she works super, super hard behind the scenes to make it look like it's easy. But she works very, very hard. And also to Dean Tyndall, Dr. Howard, everyone in administration who supported this new program and gave us the time, the energy, the resources to make it the best that it could be. So I want to make my closing remarks directly to the graduates in witness with all those attending this evening, because they have really touched my heart. First of all, congratulations. Yes, Thomas mentioned I have high standards. That's a kind way to put it. Yes, I do, because I knew they had the potential and I wanted them to reach that potential. I want to thank you all so much for your trust, your passion, and your persistence to bring your A game to every encounter, every task, every video, every assignment for these last 8 months. Together, a group of faculty, staff, and students stood on equal footing in a classroom environment and created a foundation where we built outcomes-focused course design using something they'll never forget, the course map tool. We engaged our minds and hearts to create classrooms where our learners feel safe to reach and take risks so that they can expand their skill sets. We explored evidence-based science of teaching and put those principles to the test in our teaching demonstrations. Together, we traversed tough conversations about education equity, universal course design, and classroom incivility on the part of students and faculty. We discussed how to be successful in a variety of modes of teaching, from face-to-face to hybrid to fully online. And we built our lessons in Canvas, which was remarkable. We held honest and open conversations about landing and expanding our teaching career and the practicalities of negotiating a faculty contract. We covered a lot of ground in a short period of time. But in the infamous words of Parker Palmer in the classic text, that I still refer to often, the courage to teach. Good teaching cannot be reduced only to technique. Good teaching comes from the identity and integrity of the teacher. Good teachers cultivate the capacity for connectedness. I want to thank you all for your unique identities and the integrity in the form of becoming more real, acknowledging the whole of who you are, and bringing that into your classroom environments. To close, I want to share a quote that is deeply meaningful to me, and you'll find it in my email signature line, almost as a daily reminder. Educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. Aristotle. Thank you all for opening your mind and your hearts to learn differently so you could teach magnificently. You brought out my best, you expanded my mind, and you will remain in my heart for a lifetime. I want to thank all of you, faculty, staff, students, graduates, friends, and family, and more, for your presence this evening, your support of the graduates, and sharing this historical making moment for the OEEP, Online Education and Expanded Programs. I want to thank you again, and please enjoy your evening.